So, about 3 months ago, I posted my underwater blender animation. And wow, a lot of you liked it. So, thanks to my AG buddies for wanting this breakdown, and also the comments on my video. Because today, I'm going to do a full breakdown of how I did this epic underwater animation. So, without further ado, let's get into it. So from now on, the video is gonna be a little more chill, a little bit more nice, because we're gonna start with the breakdown. I'm here in the my computer, and we're gonna try to do this. So let's see how it goes. I was using this auto track thing, so it tracks where I go. So yeah, let's just start. So I have my project here up and running. We're gonna start with the environment, okay? So let's talk a little bit about the environment, a little bit about the models I used. So as you can see here, let's see if we can put this without crashing. I don't know why. Eevee takes a lot to remember the materials, takes a lot to render with material. Okay, so now we're here and we can see a lot of things. If you see here, there's only like a couple props and that's it. All these little props and waters things, all of them I got them from Quixel Bridge, from Quixel Megascans. And I think they really work, they work fantastically. Also, most of the textures here are from there. So yeah, most of that is from there. The only thing wasn't from there was one of this chest. No, this chest I modified it. Yeah, so all the materials and everything that's from Quixel, I just put them together. Just an easy PBR material. So for the fish, which are also part of the environment, the fish are basically a particle system. There's a particle system, I think. Yeah, they're coming from here. They're coming from this plane. And there are a bunch of turbulence and vortexes here that make them kind of spin. And I think they are emitters, right? And they are in voids. They are a void particle. I have a video on how I made this fish in my YouTube channel. In another video here in the YouTube channel. So you can check it out in the description. Okay, so here we have the fish models that I made. For more variety, I made 4 types of fish. One is going slow, one is going medium slow, one is going fast, and the other one is going very fast. Basically, I just put them in a collection and made them the particle system. So now let's talk a little bit about camera placement and the lighting. So for the camera placement, I have different cameras. So this was one of the cameras. At the moment, I made this underwater short, I didn't really know how to use multiple cameras in one scene. So what I did was render one sequence with a camera angle, then move it, and then change it and move to another camera angle. So the first camera angle I did was lost, but I think I may be able to recreate it. I think so. Something like that. So for this angle, now we're gonna talk a little bit about the lighting here in my notes. So let's talk about the lighting and the rendering, which is very important. So for the lighting, I'm using cycles to render, by the way. See if this doesn't crash. Hopefully it doesn't. Because I figured a way. I'm pretty sure you've heard this if you follow Blender and stuff. I've figured out a way. So here's what it looks like. So I figured a way of make these god rays, right? So the god rays were made like this. So basically we have a huge cube that covers the entire plane, and then we have a spot lamp which has a really strong light to it, and then it goes through this texture material, which is caustic, like a caustic material. And then here's the shader. You have to copy it. So I used this mapping node to to make it move. So here you can see that it's moving, the texture is moving. So to make it a little bit more dynamic. And then just a color ramp into the alpha, really, really simple. And this, with the volumetric absorption, makes like the gut rays, okay? So yeah, that's pretty much it with the lighting. And the light, I think the light does have like a bit of a cooler tone. But later in the color grading, we'll see that really doesn't matter. But yeah, here you can see how the light is very nice coming down, and the gut rays are really, really sharp. I really like that. Okay, let's talk about the rendering. So I rendered in Cycle with 300 samples, a noise threshold of 0.1, the light sizing 4 and transparent 8 for the, you know, the caustic texture. Then, yeah, no caustics, no refractive, yeah. Basically, this all these things to speed up the render, the motion, of course, for the fish. Yeah, and persisting data, which really makes it very, very fast. I mean, yeah, very fast. And then, I really like this. This is an add-on called Super Denoiser. So, if you just add it here, add Super Denoiser. If you go to the Compositing tab, you'll see this Super Denoiser. So basically, it takes all the different output and puts in this like super group, and then you can choose what quality you want. And I think that really helped, because when I tried rendering without that, it was really slow, and yeah, and it really didn't go. It looked all mushy and stuff. And with the super tension, it looks really sharp and very good. So yeah, use that. I'll try to leave the link in the description if you want to try it out. So yeah, that's pretty much it with the scene. I did make the bubbles here with a particle system. So if you can see here better, this is a particle system. Basically, particle is just an icosphere. And then I just put it in this box. I think I followed the tutorial by Recolisten. I already know how to press it, but yeah. So it's really nice, and I made the particles with that tutorial. It turned out very good. Let me see if you can see bubbles. Oh, here it is. Here's the one here, right? And there's another one. But you just turn down the gravity and just put them on floating. And yeah, I think they come out of the volume. So yeah. Oh, by the way, the render, I don't know how much it took, but it took, I think, for one shot, for the first shot, I think it took about 30 minutes. Very fast, actually. So I'm very happy with that. So yeah, this also is a very optimized scene. Now let's move to post-production, which is in DaVinci Resolve. So now we're going to do the editing breakdown. You see there is another day. So yeah, let's just get into it. So now here we're in DaVinci Resolve. As you can see, I have the timeline here. And basically, we're gonna do a small breakdown of the editing. The editing was very simple. Just some music here, some sound effects like underwater, like bubbly. Like, let me see if you can hear this. Yeah, like some bubbly water. Then just like the music. And then we have the sound effects, and these sound effects are basically just whooshes, like water whooshes. So here, give it a listen. Yeah, just some water whooshes to make like the effects of the fish more intense, I guess. And then here we have like just some cuts where new shots are being placed. So here we have the first shot, then the second shot, then the third shot, then again the first shot, then again, and then this one. Comment down below which one is your favorite shot. I think my favorite shot has to be either the treasure or this one. I think this one is my favorite shot. Yeah, this is my favorite shot. It's like I added this effect called waviness. Can you see like how wavy those like the edges are? Yeah, that's what the effect does, and it makes it like very, very realistic because it's like underwater, right? Like the waves going through. I think that's very, that's a very nice detail. I also added some blur, as you can see here, this prison blur. And what it does is basically adds like that small vignette here. So that's a, that small vignette and that those blurry edges, which are is very nice because normally when you have a camera underwater, the center is gonna be sharp and the edges are gonna be blurry because of the light that is bent when it gets to the lens. So I think that that adds a little bit more realism. Okay, now let's go to some color grading. So here is the raw image of the color grade, and if we just add the first part, these are some curve adjustments. Then the second node is some warmth in the highlights. And then after this one, we have the LUT. And the LUT is this one right here. I don't know which one this is, but it's like a teal and orange LUT. And I reduced the strength a little. So here's a before and here's an after. See what I meant, that the light warmth, that doesn't really matter because I added the warmth after in the light. So I think that gives us a nice color contrast. So you see here how this part is warm and then here is cold, kind of like the shadows are cold and the highlights are warm. I think that gives it a very nice color contrast and color compensation that makes the image more interesting. So yeah, that's basically it. So if you liked it, subscribe and like it, and don't forget to check out this animation, and see you in the next one. Bye.